You're standing right now with 9 delegates from 100 gangs. And there's over 100 more. That's 20,000 hardcore members. 40,000 counting affiliates.
That's 20,000 soldiers, 30,000 more, not organized but ready to fight.
60,000 soldiers.
They've got 20,000 cops in the whole city, can you dig it?
Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
Veterano, old family first fam, taught the world to swing that double-edged sword, it works fam. BJJ from GJJ, like Cool Herc gave birth to which a DJ plays. But despite the lineage, I will never be closed-minded. Refuse to see beyond the lines, you go blind. Rocket travels the 10th planet, I flow free. I'm welcome on mini-mats, gi to no gi. Though my branch traces roots to the original tree, roots sprouted from the original seed. Water with blood, sweat, and tears, spotlight with sunlight. That tree became a forest, Balletudo done right. Then Hoist dominated them all in one night. And Hexon hasn't been beaten in one fight. Flow with the go, in a hit on and holly know that to continue to win, we must continue to grow. Let's go!
When they say my name is Hinachi and you stop the beat, why you did that? I'm gonna kick you on my feet. I'm the best rapper you ever felt in your life. I'm downtown LA. I got a knife in my bag. Niggas don't know you a fag. You know, it's something like that.
É, eu me lembro da tua luta. Tu ganhou em 10 segundos uma chave de braço.
Porra, caralho. Me lembro, fera. Cara, it's been a long time. In English, agora. Okay. I'm gonna talk now. I'm here, Higa Machado. We're here to talk about the old Jaime. It's been a long time since I seen you, my brother. I know you're excited to see me here.
No, it's a pleasure to be with the Master Laranja.
Of course it is.
Best of the best.
Yeah, I wouldn't say one of the best.
In Brazil, have three masters, Helio Gracie, Carlos Gracie, and Renato Laranja. That's the three guys.
You know, if I had a nickel for every time I heard that,
yes,
gonna be a rich man. Yes. But to hear from you and where, while you wearing
the mask,
that face, I look more light skin on there, but I have a chance because I look good for the summertime to get more poontang for myself. Mm-hmm. But Higan, I, you know, I know a lot of stuff's happened between us because I wanted to do in that film, that Brazilian brow.
Yeah.
And I know we had a falling out because of that stuff.
Sorry about that, because actually my agents try call your agents, but he's out of town and we couldn't reach you, but we feel very bad about that.
Yeah,
I talked to my brother, that was the biggest mistake we did in the film, not to have the Master Laranja in the movie.
Yeah, and then I remember, your brother did some movie. Jean-Jacques did a movie where he's lost in the woods with somebody.
I never seen that.
Yeah, he's my brother. Yeah, he's. Well, porra, you're not the only one. I wish I didn't saw that one too, because there's a time when he was the bad guy come to shoot him. Yeah. He's gonna kick the gun from that guy. Then he take the guy. He have like a he run to the guy like this. And he take the knife from here, yes. But before he do the arm bar, he go put the knife careful like that, he go.
Yeah, that was new.
Yeah, I don't.
I agree on that.
I don't know where they got the funding on that one, but I'm come here to.
We need to do a move together.
I wanna do. That's what I'm talking about. I wanna do Brazilian Brawl Part 2.
Let's do it.
Okay, I'm headed. It's gonna be you, me. We're not gonna. I know that I told that guy Frankie Lyles that he can be in that one, but
Frankie Lyles the world.
three-time world champion.
That guy, but we're gonna give him a part in that one. But he's gonna think we're gonna give him part on that one.
Oh, but he's a good actor. I would like to have him in the movie, man.
Listen, we don't need a guy, that old black guy, to be in that one. Okay, he's had his chime, and now it's our chime. Okay.
Okay.
So. That's okay with you?
It's okay for me. I'm kind of sad because he's my good friend.
I know. Okay. Boss, okay. Right? Listen, we're gonna find some parts to put for that black guy. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Cause in American movies, they always like to have the black friend who's gonna say some funny stuff like that. You know how they did that one. Okay. And then we're gonna kill that guy pretty early in the movie. Okay. Okay. That's how they do that one. Okay. Okay. So.
Let's do Brazilian Brawl.
Brazilian Brawl. You heard it from the horse on the mouth here. He have that one. And porra, meu
Thanks,
amigo. Valeu, fera.
Thank you very much. Meu
Valeu, cara. Porra. Porra, cara. Ah, isso. Isso. Ah. Ah, you get emotional from that. You can... I don't want you. No, don't cry. No, I know. It's been a long time. Look. I'm gonna. Ah. Whew. Oh, ah, caralho. Ah. Onde é a fera? Ah. Uai. Uai. Porra. I don't remember who's
the
boss.
You're the boss.
Okay. Tell to the people over there.
Renato Laranja.
Almost at Newcastle.
How much time until we're there?
Another 10 minutes-ish. I've got time with you, yeah. Seminar's supposed to be at 6:30.
The seminar starts when the fuck I get there. They can watch reruns of Benny Hill till we start.
Benny Hill's cool, man.
We're here at the Tap Out Gym on the corner of Pico and Grand in downtown LA. You can park across the street over there. See that parking lot right there? Leave your car there. After 8, you can park on the street. No parking problems here. Enter. Got the weight room here. Women's bathroom there. Strongest man in LA right here. Men's bathroom, really nice. Take a quick shot of that. Shower over there. Full size cage. You can have a class in there, it's so big. Completely wrapped in a cage, which is awesome. There you go. What you waiting for?
For my rock star, man.
I've got you some rock star. I've asked you already.
That was half an hour ago, man.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
I want it cold. Fresh.
Okay, cold.
And red M&Ms.
M&Ms? Oh, yeah, we've got your M&Ms here.
Oh, you actually have them?
Yeah, I've got
them. Can you pick out the red ones for me?
Yeah, Rob will have to do it. I'm driving.
Okay.
I'm on it.
Thank you. And some crumpets as well.
Shit, man, crumpet.
That fucking light off.
Yeah.
Come
into Newcastle.
This arena's been used a few times. As a dead UFC in Newcastle.
Oh, really?
They've got banners there.
Oh, well, there we go.
The British Association of Mixed Martial Arts.
Newcastle's nice. Is it like one of the nicest cities in England? It is, right? Some of the cities I've been to, they have like one stripper. She's off on Sundays and Mondays. That's it. The town stripper. That's it. I just made that up. I'm sorry. But there's got to be towns like that, right? Just have one stripper. Can you imagine the town stripper? All right, how many lap dances do you want? You go knocking on her door, he's asleep. All right, come in, have some coffee. Let me warm up the stereo. What kind of music do you like? Guns N' Roses? Let's do it. Oh, we have a girl here. I'm sorry about the strippers.
It's all right.
I totally thought we didn't have any girls here. When there's no girls, I go off. I apologize. Are you sure?
Yeah.
There's no girls, there's no kids. It's 21 and over.
It's okay.
I feel bad. This is the goal, is to eventually get to, apparently it's like Double Lotus. It's called Lotus. I thought it was Double Lotus this whole time. It's just Lotus, full Lotus, and then half Lotus. I called this single Lotus, then I called this Double Lotus. I was wrong. The yoga community, they're embarrassed by me. So I've been labeling this. So obviously, to play rubber guard, it's not rubber guard flexibility, it's just getting into Lotus, yoga pose. That's all it is. That's the goal. It's not special rubber guard flexibility, it's just yoga. If you don't have this flexibility, you can achieve it by yourself, or you can take yoga classes if you're too lazy to watch TV and work on your flexibility. Because that's all it really takes, is creating the habit where you're watching TV and you're always pulling up your legs. That's it, always. You're here, you're doing good. You're not too bad. You can barely do it with your hands. That's fine. Ultimately, you want to be able to get here without your hands. You want to just be able to just flip them up. If you want your guard to be at its maximum potential. Also, the butterfly stretch here. Your feet close together next to your twig and berries. Is that what you guys... Sausage and... what's that other one? You guys got a few of them. But being able to push your knees all the way down, that's... These two stretches, that's it. Getting eventually here, you could do these while you're watching TV. This, and then full Lotus. If you can't get to full Lotus, just do single Lotus for a while. Push your knee down, and eventually you'll be able to get full Lotus. That make sense? Unless you have titanium plates in your hips or some screws right there under your nutsack with that bone is right there that holds your asshole together. If you've got nuts right there, or nuts and bolts, then maybe you can't do it. Or maybe if your knee is, if you got a plastic knee or something, I don't know how those work. But if you don't have, if you've never had surgery, or titanium plates or metal in your knees or your hips, you can eventually get to full Lotus. I've seen it many, 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 many times. You just gotta work on it. And this kind of flexibility is crucial for the rubber guard. And not just the rubber guard. There's so many other positions that have nothing to do with rubber guard that require that yoga flexibility. So many different escapes have nothing to do with rubber guard. I can't even think of all the different ways. So many different positions. Just doing like in spider web. If you're familiar with spider web, doing the arm crushers, by the way. You need yoga flexibility to get really good at that. The jailbreak escape from side control, huge. The more flexible you are, just those two positions, that means that when you're on your back, your legs are going to be able to hit all these different zones, get back to butterfly, go from butterfly to meat hook. Go from meat hook, just swinging your legs around at an instant. If your flexibility sucks, you're not going to be able to hit those zones. There's going to be a lot of zones that you just can't get your feet into. And your jiu-jitsu will suffer, your bottom game mainly. Basically anything you can do off your back in rubber guard, you can do in the mount. And most of it's easier in the mount. So basically all the monkey mount stuff is really just rubber mount. It's the same thing. Go-go blatas from the mount, easier than from the guard. Straight jackets from the mount, easier than from the guard. All that stuff. Mono blatas, special Ks, all that. It's just a basic slow triangle. The more flexibility you have, the easier it is to hit triangles from the mount. So there's many more reasons to work on your flexibility and take it seriously than just the rubber guard. But obviously, on your back in full guard, you guys are here. You guys are definitely interested in learning the rubber guard. And if you're having trouble with it, there are non-flexible ways to play rubber guard, and we're going to go over those. But the best way is just to get on it. I mean, obviously, you guys are really into jiu-jitsu, or else you wouldn't be here. Everybody here is really into it. Everybody here, I bet, is obsessed with jiu-jitsu. Or else, why would you even be here? Working on your flexibility has to be something that you're obsessed with. You've got to get that handled. And when you get to the point where you reach the proper flexibility, you got to stay on it. Make sure you don't lose it. Everybody is born with rubber guard flexibility. Every baby plays rubber guard. They're grabbing their feet. They're sucking their toes. They're doing all that stuff. But if you don't constantly use it, your body responds. Your body is just, if you're not using your flexibility as a child, your body says, oh, he's not into that flexibility. He's into sitting on the couch and playing video games. We're going to make a body perfect for sitting on the couch and playing video games. Or playing soccer, football, or whatever. We're going to build a soccer body. Your body's growing, and it's trying to figure out what you want to do. That's why it's always easier to learn stuff when you're growing up as a child. It's easier to play piano. It's easier to learn different languages because your body's at the point now, what do you want? Let's make the body you want. And it just responds to what you tell it. I always used to think I kept my flexibility because I would put, I thought it was because I would show off. I was an insecure little kid, and I put my legs behind my head always and try to impress people. You know, if you had a double jointed shoulder, you might do this and show people at parties or whatever at school. And I thought, you know, that's why I must have my flexibility, because I was an insecure child constantly putting my legs behind my head. But then my mom comes over when I had my son, and my son was eating his toes. And my mom goes, oh, he's just like his daddy. Remember he used to eat and bite your toenails all the time as a kid? And I thought about him. That's right. I forgot about that. I would trim my toenails with my teeth growing up. I never used toenail clippers. I always used my teeth. And I use toenail clippers now. But that's what it was, because for sure I'm trimming my toenails with my teeth way more than showing off to people, my friends and stuff. So that, I think that's probably what it was, is that bad habit of chewing your toenails. So it's okay to chew your toenails, just wash your feet, and that will help with your flexibility. Because this right here, that's a good mission control right there. All right, so anyways, we're going to start off with the very beginning of the rubber guard that I never really used to teach before. Well, I always used to start with breaking down your opponent's posture in rubber guard, and then going right into perfect mission control. And there's some steps that I've been skipping. And the steps that I've been skipping, Luke, I need you. This is the way I used to teach it. My teaching is changing. I realized there's some steps that I can skip them. So this is the way I used to train people in rubber guard. He would sit up, make it nice and easy, work on his posture. He'd have
this T-Rex going on like this. Nice and easy, not 100% defense. He might not even be doing this, but this is just to get used to having someone in your guard that has this posture and going up and grabbing it and breaking it down. So the very first step is still the same. He has his posture, he's got his little T-Rex going, no big deal, and this means I better go get him, whether you're doing MMA or not. If you're doing MMA, it's even more important. Right here, I'm dead. So if he's right here in MMA, you want to get up there and go after him, clinch him. If you were boxing, you would do the same thing. You would clinch to avoid getting punched. So no matter what you're playing, there's no arm bars or no triangles that exist here without breaking his posture down. He wants solid posture. I want to break that posture. It's really simple. I can't break everyone's posture, but I'm sure going to try. I'm not going to abandon and give up until I try. I might be able to break his posture. Why would I abandon? Let's go find out if we can clinch. Always. Always find out. So the very first step is clinching up. See how my ass is off the ground? All my weight is on my hamstrings, and my left arm is all the way around just like this. No matter what, if I can get up here, I'm really good, because if I can't break his posture down, then I'll... Here, hold me up. Because either I break his posture down, or I switch and go forward, and I can mount him, he's going to push back, and then he breaks his own posture. So as long as you can get up there, and in reality, he's going to be pushing down and holding me down, and it's going to be hard. But just as a drill, just to get your mental focus together, he has posture, let's go get his posture. My left arm is all the way around his head, and we're here. All right, now this is the step that I've been skipping. I used to just... to break down his posture, get him in perfect mission control, and we want to trap one of his hands on the mat. And since I'm bringing up my left leg, that means I want to trap his right hand on the mat. That's the basic path. That's the default setting. Other things can happen. He could block that and we might move somewhere else, but you got to have a default setting. The basic path is to generally I want this hand on the mat. Why? Because, first of all, in MMA, if I have that hand trapped on the mat, you see, I'm hugging my knee, that traps the hand on the mat. He can't punch me with that. But in no-gi grappling, I want this. It has nothing to do with the punching.
This is just like an extra benefit if you're playing MMA. He can't touch me with that right hand. He can only touch, in this position, he can only touch me with the left hand, but as soon as he touches me, this leg comes up and he better stay tight or I'm gonna triangle. If he starts to punch me with that hand, then we're gonna go into a triangle. See how he can't really punch me? This is always ready for a triangle at this point. So he has to stay tight. So, once that hand's trapped on the mat, that means we can go into the next step, which is...
I like Newcastle. It looks pretty cool, man. It's like a mini London.
You know Tilly City.
I don't know Tilly City. Is that...
Drink yourself.
Just
been
getting
blurred. Monster.
That's monster.
No rock stars?
No pussy?
No, it was all ready.
Do you get the drink, pussy?
Hey, how you doing, man? Good to see you.
We're
looking
at rock stars. Now that's ridiculous.
They will, but some cases don't tell.
That's some bullshit.
Go Monster.
I'll just get the regular Monster.
That's a Monster.
Poland?
Poland.
Poland.
I want to get the
interview. Go to Poland.
It's in like a bowling green and then.
Oh, bowling. I thought he said, go to Poland. You wouldn't get it. You had to be there. Mount me, he's gonna bridge and put one hand on the mat, one hand on my chest. Not both hands on the mat, just one. He's gonna decide, so which way you're gonna go.
Claims to be Scotland's national drink. And it's advertising what proclaims to be Scotland's national drink.
Clear the neck. That's huge. That's the neck. You don't just stay in New York. unless you're hoping for a stand-up and you're just trying to stall, then that's fine. But we got to keep moving along the path. We got to clear the neck with authority, Luke. So now, we're going to start from the top here. And now that we understand that drill, don't forget that drill. We're just going to work on one side, okay? So now that we understand how important it is to take advantage of those free New Yorks, now we're going to go through the basic path with the zombie on one side. Just get one side nice and strong. You guys understand what's going on now. You need the last couple drills we did. You need to drill that as much as you can until it's in your DNA. Break it down. Same way.
Can you dig it?
Run, and I don't know where I'm ending up. Trekking the globe makes it hard for me to stay in touch. I'm on the run, cause I'm more than just the place I'm from. Taking control of my destiny is number one. I'm on a space trip to the sun. Guerrilla tactics, actions louder than flows. With just a fraction of the anti-passive passion.
Invisible calling requires a lot of flexibility. You have to have serious flexibility. So obviously most of you guys aren't at that point where you can play invisible caller. So in the invisible, if you can't cross your feet to invisible caller, then that foot needs to either go on the hip, where it originally was, or leg curl over his back. That's it. Foot on the hip, leg curl, or cross your ankles. Crossing the ankles is the best. Invisible collar is the best. But if you don't have the flexibility, sometimes you don't have the right angle. Sometimes I can't even hit invisible collar, just at a bad angle. It all depends how the guy's smashing you and stacking you. Sometimes you can't. But it's always the best. That should always, ultimately, you should always work on your flexibility. Just like I was telling this guy over here who's having some flexibility issues. I've seen guys go from shit flexibility to perfect flexibility in a month or two because every 20 minutes a day, they were militant about it. Then I've seen guys get their flexibility together, go from shit flexibility to good flexibility in 5 or 6 years. Because it all depends on your work ethic. You know, if you have a hard time watching TV and working on your flexibility. All you gotta do is watch TV and sit in the butterfly stretch and just push your knees down while you watch TV. Have some berries, have a beer, or whatever you have to do. It's easy. You can watch whatever you want. You don't have to watch educational TV. You can watch Mob. You guys get Mob Wives out here? You guys get Mob Wives? You guys, I haven't seen the show, but Dave told me about The Undateables. That sounds amazing. I want to watch that. Is it good? Is it good or is it not that good? Is it good? It's kind of dark. Hey, you know, it sounds interesting. Anyways, just watch TV. It's so easy. It doesn't have to. You don't have to watch jiu-jitsu videos. You can watch anything. It's just this. Pushing the knees down here, and obviously we have flexibility issues. We're doing half lotus, trying to get this foot up, pushing the knees down again. Just leaning down, just like this. Either side. And you'll see slowly the flexibility will come together. You just have to want it enough. And it's not just for rubber guard. There's so many other positions where your flexibility is going to come into play and save your ass. So it's just like the striking arts. You can't kick to the head. Unless you're going to quit, you're going to train to kick to the head. And you don't even question anybody because when it comes to striking arts, they've been around so long, you don't question it. Like, oh, we need to kick to the head. I can't kick to the head. I got to stand in the corner, put my foot in that rope thing, and you got to work on your stretching. No one even questions it. No one walks out of a kickboxing gym or a karate school and says, you know what, I can't kick to the head. This is just not for me. No one ever thinks that because it's been done so much. Everybody knows that you work on your flexibility, eventually you can kick to the head. And then eventually you can barely reach the head. Look, I can barely reach the head. At first you're kicking midgets in the head, but eventually you're kicking to the head but without any power because you're barely getting up there. And eventually your legs are going to be so rubbery, bam, you just snap them up and really put some weight into it, put your hip into it, That's the same thing with this flexibility. If you don't have the discipline to watch reality TV and just do this, and you need someone to constantly push you, do yoga three days a week. Because no one's ever done yoga for 10 years and not been able to get into Lotus eventually. If you're doing yoga and you're dedicated, it's about stretching and holding poses. Eventually, you need someone to walk you through. You need to go to classes. Take yoga 3 days a week. Jiu-jitsu 2 days a week. Or whatever. Get together with your wife or your girlfriend. Go to yoga. You guys are doing something together. You know, whatever. Or you could just do the Lotus stretch and the butterfly stretch while watching TV every day. The goal is to do it so much that you don't even have to think about it anymore. It's just a habit. It's just, you just, anytime you sit, you're just bullshitting with your friends. You're like, can you believe that time? And you're just like this. You're like, I told her I'm not going to fucking take out the trash while fucking Undateables is on. We can wait till afterwards. What's the difference? I take it out now or after the shows? And she's insane. You know, but look I'm bullshitting and I'm right here. That's the goal, is to be able to just hang out and just listen to some nonsense, and you're on the bus. I drive and I'm like this. I sleep sometimes and I'm like this. Just maintenance. That's the goal. And you don't have to think about it, and you're just doing it because it's a habit, it's not that hard to get to. That's when you're going to work on your flexibility and you're not even trying to. People start making fun of you, like, oh, look at him. Look, he's grabbing his toes all the time. He just sits there and just pulls his foot up. He's insane. That's a good thing.
That's my rule.
Man, it stinks out there.
Yeah, I like this.
It smells like mildew.
Mildew.
Is this your dojo?
Just mildew.
Oh, what nice. Is this?
But why is it like that?
Well, just storage. So I'm not rolling in for a bit like in the weight room here.
Look at you, man.
Took it
out. Oh, shit.
Kettlebell.
Look at you.
Yeah, darn. And then I'm...
Dude, you got those 1980s. Badass.
Oh, look at that. He's got the fucking mask
on. Got them all?
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Nice.
Dude,
so,
nice.
We gotta come to Sam's Bar.
Jiu-jitsu
and drums. Oasis in the house. Do you act? When was the last time you actually hit that bag seriously?
A year ago.
Okay. Look at this. He's got a fucking. Look, he's got life out there. He's got the science there. Look at this shit.
It's all right, huh? All right,
huh? You got 2 bars.
Okay.
You're out of control.
Busy bar, the one I've got over there, mate. Do you go to Chester too much?
Nah.
Busy, like.
Chester Lee Street. You gotta have Hills Have Eyes people over there, though. You can say that. We had science.
Hills Have Eyes.
Cutaways.
What was the line before he got handcuffed? When he's like making, he's like running, and then he sees a bitch sitting there, and he goes, "Hold on, what was all that shit before he gets cuffed?"
He says something like, they say,
"They're running, right? They're running from the baseball."
No, they're just kind of walking at that point. They've already chinned the baseball fuse, and they're walking, and they just type of one and walk past her. And he's like that, it's there for free. And they're like that, we've got to meet the others. And he's saying, come on, it's there for free. And
he says that it's there
then,
for free.
Then he says, I'm going back. And he says, you all must be going faggot.
Yeah. And then when he comes back, and what was the first shit he tells that
shit? He kind of just throws the baseball bat down and he's like that. Hey lady, are you okay? You know, don't you know that it's unsafe in the park after midnight or something?
Lady! When she handcuffed him, he starts making out with her. Yeah. She's like, stop, relax, relax.
He says, struggle, I like it rough.
Yeah.
I like it when something like
that. And then he gets handcuffed and then what?
Yeah.
Lady.
And then she radios it.
Never trust a hooker with a walkie-talkie.
Punches.
Oh, did you know that was an old jug?
No.
He goes, the only thing, he learned one thing in college. Never trust a hooker with a walkie-talkie. I was like, oh, that's early Rogan. That's pre-weed Rogan.
Oh, he talked about that on the show.
Right?
Pre-weed Rogan.
Yeah, never trust a hooker with a walkie-talkie.
I'm going to get this in.
Damn.
Sam's got a plus one.
It's not been used.
Yeah.
Put your finger in there.
You heard my fleshlight story, right?
Yeah, it's not been yours.
Have you heard my fleshlight? You haven't heard my fleshlight story.
I've never seen one. I flew in a girl when
I was single. You probably haven't heard this either.
It's not been yours. You're lying. You'll put your cock in that. You must have done one.
Back when I was single, I used to fly in chicks from all of I used to find chicks on MySpace, and then we're down to fly in. We probably won't put this in, but we probably shouldn't videotape this.
No.
But I'd fly in chicks, and generally would work out. Generally, if a bitch got flown in, she would have the IQ to realize that I'm going to fuck her.
A little bit more.
Right? Right? You just got a fucking plane ticket to L.A. Your pussy better be ready. Right? Every now and then, I think maybe just once this happened. I flew in some chick I met on MySpace, flew her in, and the bitch wasn't down to fuck. Friday night, I'm making moves. I flew her on Friday night. Her flight back to Texas was Sunday. And she wasn't responding at all. I couldn't even kiss this bitch on Friday night. It was ridiculous. So Saturday morning, I wake up and I just wait. This is like... I knew that this shit could happen. I'm like, damn, this is a bad one. This bitch is so not down. So, I have this bitch all Saturday day. I'm going to get laid. So I drove her to a sex shop, the Hustler shop. Drove her to the sex shop, Hustler shop, to pick out one of them fleshlights. Like, I'm going to fuck something. So I took her to the shop to pick out a fleshlight that I could fuck. She couldn't believe it. Picked it out, picked the best one out, took it back home, and I fucked that shit. I told her, I'm going to fuck something. So I fucked a little fleshlight, and then the next morning, I sent her home, and I never talked to her since.
How was the fleshlight? No answers back, no telling tales.
There's something about, you know, when you jerk off, the reason it's not as good as real pussy is your own feelings counteract something. It does feel good enough to bust a nut, but the fact that that's your own hand, it counteracts like something.
So what about the fleshlight?
But the fleshlight, that's not your own shit. So when you're fucking that, you're like, it's way better than jerking up. It's better. The only problem is you gotta clean up the mess. You know, you gotta rinse it out, you gotta clean it up.
I can't remember.
Yeah, it's better. You know, the problem is when you bust the nut, you got a mess that you gotta clean up. They need to make a fleshlight that's disposable, that it's so cheap, that as soon as you nut, you can just throw the whole thing away.
The fleshlight.
But it's fucking like $50 or something. So you have to wash that shit. You can't just throw it. A jerk off can't cost $50, so you gotta wash it. You're in the fucking sink, rinsing it out, and you feel like dog shit. You're like, ugh, I'm so gross. I just nutted in this fucking contraption. But if it was $3, I would have no problem. I'd buy a fucking 10-pack, bust it out, just throw it away. And just wipe up and then just watch TV.
Biodegradable ones.
But the fact is you can't, that's a lot of money. You gotta wash it. So you're sitting there washing for 5 minutes and rinsing it out. That's the bitch. They need to figure out a fleshlight that costs $3. $8. I'll even pay $8.
Raise the stakes.
Yes. $8.
Not $9.99.
I'll pay $9.99 for a jerk off session, but then you'd want it every day. Then God damn it, how much is $10 a day for 30 days straight? What is that? $300?
That's like a car payment, man. And then, it, you know what? It can't be 99.
Yeah.
It's a car payment. Unless you do it 3 times a week. 3 times 4, that's 12. 12 times what? 10? $120 a month. That's a car payment still. That's a cheap ass, that's a smart car. So it's got to be $3. $3. Once it's $3, then you're dumb, you can just throw it away. You just put it right in the garbage. You don't have to rinse it out like a fucking loser. Trying to save it for one more. You know?
Clean up your own man juice.
So you would
life juice.
You would put $3 for that. You would stack that up against your monthly subscription.
Yes. If it was $3 per
month. Yeah, every month you get a free subscription.
I would buy a 36-pack. And every other month I'd just have it like an auto pay. And they just, you get a package every 3 months.
If you operated the company, would you give people a deal if they had the jiu-jitsu and that signed up for the Fleshlight as well?
I would separate it. I wouldn't
come. You wouldn't give them, like, it's three, three, yeah. But if you sign up for both, it's 5.
I would not mix the jiu-jitsu and the jerk-off toys. I'd keep that separate.
Sean Shearer comes out training masks, doesn't he, when he does seminars in Yokohama, Flashlights. But you'd have to have dildos as well, wouldn't you, because you've got women.
Yeah. That's the problem we'd have to figure out.
Oh, you could offer them a personal tour. We'll kick in, right? You're like, I went into a gym the other day and thought, hey, it was so quiet and so good.
That's what we're talking about. His wife wakes up. Dave! Trying to sleep!
That's far too much.
Damn, look at that. That's like an old lady's ass.
How many old ladies' asses have you seen?
Two, man. I don't want to talk about it. Edit that out.
That's Dr. Bravo's old lady's ass.
Save that for a podcast.
Yeah, that's just too much. We can't talk about it. There's too many ass out there. Damn, it's only 10:30. Holy shit, it's early.
Retired?
Yeah,
retired. Health problem.
No, thanks.
Yeah, if you're not
So, you're there, big man.
Yeah, I'll just keep it in, mate. All I want.
That's far too much. You're gonna be
fucked. Well, wait.
You're gonna be fucked up that one.
Wait a minute, you took the whole thing?
Two
fulls.
You're fucked now by
then. Oh, AJ.
This is my.
How are you gonna drive home?
We're gonna fly.
Did you get that? Did you get the question? Did you get the weed that he blew out?
Yeah.
Oh man, this right there, that's a 5-second clip right there. How are you gonna, it's gonna be, how are you gonna drive? We're gonna fly.
We're gonna fly home.
That's it. On a DeLorean. He's like thinking you're smoking all my weed, man.
Let me get four.
Soon they're gonna make bags that don't crunkle free bag, right? So you can get high with your parents in the next room. The commercials will be, and the noise, and the mother comes in, oh, what are you doing? Oh, is this you? No. The crunkle-free bag. They're gonna be kids doing that shit as their parents are sleeping, they have mother and father go. Crunkle-free volcano.
Right,
Rob,
cut that out. I need to get the gossip. What happened?
So now, we're gonna back up a bit. We're gonna back up a bit and get into a move that one of my black belts, Scott Epstein, came up with, and he put me to sleep with it. I didn't have faith in it, and it's a move that. It's beautiful when you can't get that hand on the mat. You couldn't get a free New York. The zombie's not working, and you're in crackhead control. Crackhead control doesn't require as much flexibility as invisible collar.
but they're related. So, still, this is one that hopefully most of you guys can do. So let's say I broke the guy down.
Show shooting like stars, I travel the globe, zooming your view like a Truman alone. Root of the bone, roof getting blown. Off of this motherfucker, bury my soul. Now that you know, take it and try. Nobody's gonna make it out alive. You're probably gonna wanna pray to Christ. Take a moment to breathe and heed advice. Weaving these webs to see to lies. Attracts every angle, creed and type. I knew that I couldn't believe the hype. I knew I had to see it in a different light. I knew I gotta do whatever I gotta do to make it, make a difference, and make it my revenue. Hard times held quiet, kept. When they caught Ed O'Brien, it's a tiny mess. When it's stretching in time to abide for a check. Heating the chest over civil unrest. Sick of the symptoms, tired to rest. Proceed with persistence, push to progress. Cease to believe a dream, might as well be mentally deceased. Might as well just learn to like defeat. You only get one chance to be unique. Every fan that felt the fucking beat. I'll spit my throat if you speak. Just let the song that's on the scene. Just let it go until you're free. I'm dead, records and bottles through the air. Just when you thought we were out. All right, guys. The next transition now, we're gonna go from same concept that we've been doing earlier, getting the hand trapped to the mat before we even get to rubber band. And one of the most important ways to do that is those free New Yorks are basically your opponent having a lapse of positioning for a second, and you capitalize it. If he had his left hand on the mat, you hug your right knee. You got his right hand on the mat, you hug your left knee. It's up to him, the mistake. He put his hand on the mat, he was in full guard, and he's had his hand on the mat. You made him pay for that lightning quick mistake, all right? But, so if I'm in, if I have him in full guard, he doesn't want his hands on the mat, never. He has his hands on the mat, that's a big problem. But in butterfly guard, here, he doesn't want to be like this, because then I'll sweep him easily. His butterfly guard means I'm going to try to sweep. He wants his hands on the mat here. So if I have him in butterfly guard, it's easier to get his hands on the mat. You know, if we're playing two on one here, maybe I'm trying to sweep him this way, and he steps up on this knee, and we take him this way, or whatever. I got my butterflies in. He wants his hands on the mat to stop the sweeps. Right? So that hand on the mat is good if I had him in full guard. So what I want to do is,
well, my brother, Frank, this is gonna be a big movie to your career, okay?
Yes.
I know that you didn't have a lot of hits since you was in the group Levert.
That wasn't me. But okay, I understand. But that wasn't me.
Okay, but anyway, I know you had a big H&B career. And you sold a lot of records, a lot of soul stuff on the 80s and stuff like that. And now I'm going to have you to, I know you're going to play a big chuff. We need a black guy in the movie.
Okay.
To be the comic relief. we got a lot of bad guys, a lot of tough guys, Brazilian guys, real tough guys. Okay, who's gonna do some Brazilian jiu-jitsu, gonna do some capoeira. Okay. But we need a black guy to say stuff like, you know, when some stuff's going down, some block, you go, God damn, that stuff is like, ooh, baby. You know, that one like that, and you're gonna be like, I ain't, that ninja stuff like that gonna come, and you're gonna go, man, I wish I never seen no shit like that in my life. Let's get out of here. Boom, you gotta hit somebody like that. You know, okay, and we're gonna be like, that black guy, boy, come on, we're gonna save you. Stuff's like, oh, my brother, you know, I got so excited I spit on there.
It's okay. I was under the impression from Higgy Machado, he told me the motivation was gonna be a little bit different.
He told you the motivation gonna be different. Let me tell you something. Higgy Machado's don't run the show. I'm the one who's I'm the boss on this one. Because I know it's called Brazilian Brawl too. It was the first one they left me out of there, but now I'm the one bring the finance and stuff like that.
He said there's a big budget in this.
It's a big budget. It's gonna be a little more than the last one. You saw the last one. Yeah. We made a lot of money off a little.
I'm a big fan of it.
You're gonna see a lot of money on the back end. You're not gonna see nothing up front. Who's that? Oh, okay. So let me tell you something, my brother. I gotta make sure the only thing, I can't bring you in the studio if you don't have it. You know, somebody said you know how to do some boxing, stuff like that. I wanna see what kind of strike you work with. I wanna see you to shadow box. And don't worry about that stuff over there.
So as it from a southpaw or from orthodox?
What's your favorite way to do that?
Southpaw.
Okay, you're gonna go southpaw. That's gonna confuse a lot of the guys. Okay? And I like that. Okay. So we're gonna go and you're gonna show me some of the stuff. So just do me some shadow box here for, I'm gonna send you the producer. You gotta keep to do that. And then when you say some stuff like that, imagine you're gonna say some like, hey, Jive Cherokee, you know, stuff that the black guys that they say a lot of catch word when they do some fight, like, hey, take that, your jive time is close to Thanksgiving, but you being a Jive Cherokee, something like that. You know, get done some stuff. Yeah. I gotta have a black guy who's gonna wanna be in the program. I got a lot of guys who wanna be in your shoes.
And I wanna be here, but I just don't.
Let me tell you something. When you throw at punches, you don't throw like that.
I got
okay.
You.
Sometimes you seen those that black guys having more shocking jiving style like that. They throw a lot of stuff like that. And when I do some capoeira, I might throw in some stuff like that. Porra, caralho! I catch the guy to slap.
Okay.
So my brother, I'm gonna have you in there.
Yes.
I'm gonna have you in there. We're gonna train you. I'm gonna teach you some capoeira.
Okay.
And gonna teach you some black stuff to say, some better stuff. And don't worry, you're not gonna have to do it that long. We're gonna kill you. Maybe like a quarter that way, the movie. But we're gonna be sad. That thing is, we're gonna be sad from that. It's gonna motivate. We're gonna go, why you killed that black guy? It's the only black guy we have that team.
That's refreshing.
That's refreshing. Don't saw something like that. We go, we're gonna deal with that guy who killed that black guy on our team. He was the best guy. And when you come on the screen, you're gonna hear saxophone music. So that they know, hey, listen, yeah, it's a black guy, he's don't play around. And you're gonna hear like that stuff like that.
Okay.
I'm telling you, we're gonna do a top notch on that one. We're not gonna spare expense. Okay?
Okay.
You're gonna be happy with that.
I'm trying to follow in the tracks of my best friend, Michael Jai White. So if this is what it's gonna take, then I wanna.
Your best
wanna,
friend, look, that's Black Dynamite.
Look what kind of stuff
he did for Black Dynamite. He did for black people and dynamite people from the 70s. What you're gonna do for guys who was boxers on the 80s.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, I'm willing to try.
Yeah.
I mean, it's gonna...
Hey, Frankie.
Brother.
I ain't not gonna steer you wrong, so, brother.
Okay.
Okay? The Jive Cherokee ain't gonna, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, I appreciate it.
So, brother.
Okay.
Number one.
Okay. I got you.
You're a strong guy, my brother.
Appreciate it.
Your heart is strong.
Thank you for the exposure.
Oh, yeah, my God, I know you're a man of Christ. By my God, I'm going to change your career.
I appreciate it.
I'm going to make you be better and stuff.
Thank you.
Okay, my brother?
Yes, I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it.
And, let's do like they did that stuff. And the fight, the backhand side. Okay. You know how they did that? Okay? So that's the dynamite bomb. And you heard it straight from... these guys, the heel next black celebrity on the scene. Yes, and stay black, porra.
Us.
Remove the two-on-one stuff and make it nice and easy for you, okay? That was probably just a little too much for you, but just remember that. The two-on-one stuff will set up those overhooks. Just remember that, all right? I was on the fence of whether I should have gone into that or not. It's a lot for you, but I threw it out there. Just remember the two-on-one stuff that Marcelo is doing will get you to the cocoon, and the cocoon is this. We're just gonna start from here. We're in butterfly guard. I have a deep overhook and neck control. And my head's on his shoulder. I'm tight. We're clinching. His upper body is clinched. He let me get in deep. If I just had the overhook here, he could pull out. Here, neck control and the overhook, he can't pull out. He pulls out, I go up with him. All right? So from here, once you have the cocoon, butterfly guard, overhook. Grab your own pack. Tight. Flip your butterfly.
If you want to walk down the bottom of the hill, this is about 700,000 years up the wall.
You're in for a surprise. In for a shot. Can't hit that note, man. He only killed Jack the Ripper. Only killed hookers, right?
That's what I heard. Yeah.
So what's the problem? No, that is a problem. You can't be killing hookers, especially hot ones. I don't know if we could put that in.
Scoop the leg, Chris. Scoop the leg.
Nice! Yeah.
Nice, Quito.
No.
Nice. Vamos a montarlo. Montalo, montalo.
Get that half, Chris. Bust that half. Go for that. Go for that darts. Get it, Chris.
There you go.
Don't forget.
I
need
nice. Nice.
Wilson Juarez, Joshua Hendricks, Brendan Rotella, and Adam Mims. Please report to the staging area. Wilson Juarez, Brendan Rotella, Joshua Hendricks, and Adam Mims.
Oh, shit. Ahí está. Ahí está.
Oh, shit.
Nice, Larry, nice. Stay on.
There you go. There you go.
Get your arm out
nice,
of here.
Nice, Quito.
Larry snaps his legs in his back.
Yeah, but he's got a fucking baseball back control right now. So well, back, he pulls his back. He was like, really hard right now. Oh, I guess he hit it. I didn't see him go behind the head.
Yeah,
I think he's got
it. Hey, Quito!
Yeah, Quito!
Like I said earlier, guys, if you're interested in progressing in the system, if you're interested in what me and all of my moon heads, my head instructors, have put together and have gathered, and for £3 a month, you have access to mastering the system, which includes everything we've been able to figure out and put together. The goal for 10th Planet Jiu-Jitsu, for me, it's all fun. I just want the best Jiu-Jitsu system for the UFC. Jiu-Jitsu didn't get me into the UFC. The UFC got me into Jiu-Jitsu. To me, it's more satisfying to see my guys eventually make it to the UFC and see what 10th Planet and the whole association has put together. That's the goal. The goal is not to be have to leave out some techniques because we don't like Russians because they came up with it. Fuck the Russians. Or fuck the Brazilians. Fuck the English. I don't give a shit if you're my enemy. You got some good stuff. I learned a lot from people that I don't like at all. That means nothing to me. There's some people I do not like at all. They're just douchebags. But they got some good stuff and they figured some shit out. And I'm going to take that because I know the 10th Planet Association will benefit for me not caring whether I like the person or not. All that matters to me is we put together the best stuff. And we have a mastering system. We probably have 53 episodes. This is going to be a mastering the system episode. Every school that I stopped at, every seminar I did, that's going to be a different episode. It's going to be a whole, it's going to be 5 episodes back to back to back, and this is going to be one of them as well. So every seminar I did something different. We had some guys that are doing all of them, like Christian here. He's coming to all of them. I didn't want to do the same thing for him. So next time I come out, I'm going to try to do this twice a year, hit 5-6 schools. There's more. There's Scotland's coming soon. Steve Thompson from Scotland. Where is he at? That's Carluke.
That's it.
Carluke, Scotland. That's coming soon. They're going to be popping up everywhere. I'm going to have to do this like once every 6 months, hopefully. And just know next time that I'm trying to do something different every time to leave as much knowledge here as possible. All right, so to keep up to date with everything, like I said, £3 a month, I try to make it as cheap as possible. It would be cool if I could do it for free and then still pay for my house. That would be cool, but I have to charge a little something, okay? So I'm giving you all I have. I'm trying to do my best, the best I possibly can. I'm keeping an open mind and trying to gather all the best MMA jiu-jitsu techniques that are going to spill over to the no-gi grappling scene as well. But my main focus is how jiu-jitsu looks on the grand stage, how jiu-jitsu looks to the entire world. And that's the UFC. UFC, that's what everyone's looking at. You know, you got all these tournaments all over the world and high school gyms and all that. That's important to me too. Not nearly as important is how it looks to the world. So that's my goal. That's why I dropped the gi. I dropped the gi to make jiu-jitsu look, to do my part in the making jiu-jitsu as effective and as the most comprehensive style possible. Anything I see that could add, that I could add that's going to benefit, hell yeah. I got a lot of people that are joining Tenth Planet, and I'm doing it for them. I want everyone to be satisfied. I don't want anyone to think that we're shutting anything off because of some stupid bias reasons, or because we're closed-minded. None of that stuff. Okay?
In 2011, the Korean zombie Chan Sung-jung made his UFC debut and set out to avenge what was a controversial decision loss to Leonard Garcia. He got the W, but it was the way he did it that had the MMA world buzzing. Jung employed the complex submission move known as the Twister to get the finish. Now for a closer look at how he pulled it off, we've called upon Eddie Bravo, the man credited with inventing the move, in this edition of Gracie Breakdown.
I'm Henner Gracie.
And I'm Eddie Bravo.
And today we're breaking down the first twister submission in UFC history.
Beautifully executed by the Korean zombie against Leonard Garcia at UFC Fight Night.
So it was round two. The zombie was laying it down.
Yep! Oh my goodness!
Leonard Garcia was on his back in open guard. The zombie was standing over him. At this point, he has two options, turn in or turn out. He chose to turn out. Bad idea. When he got up at this point, the zombie got both hooks in and double underhooks. The zombie wanted to flatten Leonard out belly down, which would have been great, but Leonard didn't let it happen, very stocky guy that he is. So they rolled over, and they ended up belly up right here, and this is when the twisting began.
At this point in MMA and in jiu-jitsu, this is the be-all, end-all. You're on your opponent's back, you go for the rear naked choke. He's trying to spin into me, trying to get into my guard. I'm trying to maintain back control. But in MMA these days, it's getting harder and harder to get the rear naked choke. So now there's options. And the option that Korean Zombie chose is the twister. The twister is a lot like back mount, but it's, instead of having both hooks, I have one hook and I'm off at an angle. And I'm still attacking the neck, but I'm going over his arm and attacking the neck here.
Right now, my lower body is fixed at a certain twisted angle towards you guys. And what Eddie's doing by trapping my arm here and pulling my head is he's literally twisting my upper body in the other direction. Listen, to be clear, my friends, some of you are watching right now and they don't fully respect the pain that I'm feeling. Come back. You know when you were a kid and you got the doll and you twisted it off of its axis and it broke? That's what he's doing right now. He's twisting the cervical, everything's messed up in here. So it's very uncomfortable, very dangerous.
In defending against the punches and the choke, Leonard Garcia held Korean Zombie's right arm out, which made the transition, removing one of the hooks, sinking the other hook in deeper, made the transition seamless and easy. Yeah. And he ended it with 1 second left here.
He's set up a twister, it looks like. He is. He's got a twister. Oh! 9 seconds of the round.
He's got it!
Oh!
If Leonard Garcia was well-versed in this, there would have been a battle here, and he would have lasted to the end of the round.
Once it's locked, it's pretty bad. And if it's this guy on your back, you're probably not gonna get out. But if it's anyone else, and it's in the second or third round, and they're sweaty, and things are slippery, when this lockup or this process is beginning where the hand does get isolated, which we never wanna let happen, but if the arm does get isolated, there is one last minute, what we call emergency escape. And that would be dealing with this. Look at this right here. Look at these feet right here. That hook is messing everything up for me. What I do is I take my free leg, I stomp on his shin, keep it tight, Eddie. I unhook this, and now the twist prevention capabilities of Eddie's legs are lost. At this point, I can easily face and remove my leg.
Chan Sung-jung by submission! Somewhere, Eddie Bravo is very happy.
So there it is, my friends, the first twister submission in UFC history.
And it won't be the last.